नमस्कार, मायसेल्फ लेफ्टनंट डॉक्टर प्रशांत आंबेकर फ्रॉम धर्मपेठ साइंस कॉलेज नागपूर।
एंड आई एम जसमीर कौर रंधावा आंबेकर फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज नागपुर। वेलकम यू टू द फोर्थ मॉड्यूल ऑफ फिजिक्स एक्सपेरिमेंट। इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी आर स्टडिंग ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर इन इन्वर्टिंग एंड नॉन इन्वर्टिंग मोड। An op-amp is a differential amplifier. It shows near to ideal characteristics, like it has very large input impedance, small output impedance, and very high voltage and current gain. Basically, it has two input terminals called inverting and non-inverting input terminals. The output voltage is out of phase when input is connected to inverting terminal, whereas the output is in phase when input is connected to non-inverting terminal. Along with other basic characteristics, one more is there, that is, operational amplifier has very large bandwidth.
Let us see the pin configuration of commonly used op-amp IC741. Here, this IC is basically 8-pin IC, in which the pin number 1 and 5 are offsetional, pin number 2 is an inverting input, pin number 3 is a non-inverting input, pin number 4 and pin number 7 are negative VCC and positive VCC. Pin number 6 is the output of this op-amp, whereas pin number 8 is a not connected pin.
The circuit diagram here shows the operational amplifier connected in inverting mode. The inverting terminal is supplied with input power V in through a resistance RI. A feedback resistance RF is connected between V out and RI. As we all know that input impedance of operational amplifier is very large, no current is supposed to enter into it. Therefore, whatever is the current entering through the resistance RI, it will pass through RF and come out at or seen at the output. So, we have basically a linear series combination of RI and RF, where the inverting node is at zero potential. Applying Kirchhoff's current law at this node, we get an equation for the summation of current as specified here. By rearranging the terms in this equation, we get a relation that VO upon VI is nothing but minus RF upon RI, but VO upon VI is nothing but the voltage gain. So this equation specifies that voltage gain is a user defined parameter which will be a function of the feedback resistance and input resistance. So user can have the value of voltage gain as per his or her requirement. One more thing here, seeing that the gain is negative, so output will be always out of phase with the input. The non-inverting terminal is grounded.
In this experiment of inverting mode of op-amps, that is operational amplifier, I am using here an op-amp IC741 IC. Its terminals are number 1 terminal is offsetional, number 2 is inverting terminal which is connected via this line. I have taken out two connections from this with this green wire. Number 3 is a non-inverting terminal. Now in this case I have connected it to ground, and number 4 terminal is negative VCC. I have taken out from this negative line over here. Again, number 5 is again another offset null. Then number 6 is the output. I have taken it from here so that I could get multiple connections over here. And the last one is number 7 terminal of the IC, that is positive of the VCC. Now the 8th terminal of this IC is not connected. Begin with the inverting terminal. I have taken it at two places, one over here and one over here. So I have taken two resistances, as this is a bypass resistance. That means from inverting terminal to the output terminal, that is this yellow line. So this is bypass and this is input resistance. So I have taken this as another line. This line is connected over here, and it is connected via the input, that means the waveform generator. You can have waveform generator in the form of either sine wave, triangular wave or square wave. So you can choose any one of these. Then the third terminal, that means non-inverting terminal, I have connected via this line to the negative of the exercise kit, that means ground terminal, you can say. Now here for IC biasing, I have taken two terminal, that is from one from 7 and another from 4, that is negative and this is positive. I have taken it to the another, see, minus V and plus V. This terminal is output. I have taken it at A2, and this is input via this 10k resistance, and that is taken to the A1 terminal of the exercise kit. Now connections are made. Now we have to see how it performs. So friends, let us start with the experiment. Now I am opening the exercise 17 and it is already selected at the oscilloscope. So I have to select the inverting amplifier. Now I will show you the connections here. Now you can see it is already selected at A1, so I will select it A2 also. And as my input have to be very small, I will consider it as 80 millivolts, or set it at 80 millivolts. I will select the proper or appropriate range for this, and I am getting this kind of response. Now if you see A1, already we have seen that the A1 terminal is nothing but connected to the input. So this is my input and this is my output. It is exactly opposite, that means out of phase to the input. Now it means that the input which is connected to pin number 2 is giving me output at pin number 6 in this form. That means inverted output. The input has been inverted and giving me this kind of output. So therefore it is called as inverting amplifier. Now if I increase the voltage, you may get similar kind of thing, but having magnitude a bit larger. So I have selected again both the ranges over here for 4 volt. You can have the value of the amplitudes. You can see here it is 1.00 volt at a frequency of around 1000 volt, which already I have selected here with a sinusoidal input. Now if you want to select the input triangular, you can get the triangular output, again inverted type. And if you want to again select it square wave, you will get this kind of square wave. This kind of this portion particularly is the loading effect. It may be appearing due to some technical problem, or but whatever you supply at the input, you will be getting at the output. So this completes this sinusoidal, or you can say the inverting amplifier in AC mode. Now if you want to see the DC mode amplifier, we have to see, or you have to change a bit of circuit diagram as shown in figure. So we will change it and then come to it again. As you know that this WG is only delivering either sinusoidal or triangular or square wave. If I want to have DC potentials, I may connect it to either PV1 or PV2, and if I connect it, then I may get the output as DC voltage. Now I have selected DC mode, so I have to find the DC voltages over here. Now my A1 is again input and A2 is output, so A1 is almost 0, A2 is again 0. I won't need this frequency and voltage in AC mode. Now I will select my voltage from PV1 because my input is at PV1. So let us consider I will select 0.1 volt, and I am getting this is 0.1 positive. At the same time, the output at pin number 6, I am getting minus 0.1, or you can see these voltages over here, see minus 0.1. If I select it minus 4 or 5 volt, we will get this kind of result. If you want to select it 1 volt, you will get this is plus volt and this is minus volt. Again, you can raise it to 1.5 volt, you will get minus 1.5 volt. You can see it here. So, this is the sort of inverted output what I am giving it to the inverting amplifier's input. I will select 3 volt and I am getting this kind of inverted output. So this completes the explanation on inverting mode of operational amplifier.
For the non-inverting amplifier configuration, the inverting terminal is connected to ground through a resistor R2. The feedback resistance R1 is connected between the output terminal and inverting input terminal. The non-inverting terminal is provided with the input Vin. As no current flows through the amplifier, therefore the concept of virtual ground tells us that whatever is the voltage available at non-inverting terminal will also be seen at the inverting terminal. Therefore, applying the concept of Kirchhoff's current law to the potential divider arrangement formed between R1 and R2, we get a relation as shown: Vi minus Vo by R2 plus Vo minus 0 by R1 is equal to 0. That is the current flowing through the feedback resistance, and the resistance R2 are the same. By arranging the terms, we get the relation for Vo upon Vi as 1 upon Rf upon Ri, which is nothing but the voltage gain Av.
Very small changes in this circuit, I can make it the circuit for non-inverting mode of amplifier. Now see, in this case the ground terminal is connected to negative that means the non-inverting terminal, and these inverting terminals are connected to the WG as well as A1. Now if I use these two terminal at the place of this ground and ground to this particular terminal, then that means ground to negative or inverting mode, and these two WG and A1, that means sensor, and this WG, that means source, connected to non-inverting mode, that means input. Now so I will be getting the amplifier as non-inverting mode amplifier. So let us do that. I will remove this and I will have this connection over here. I will have another this connection over here, and I will connect this to this terminal, that means input terminal. So my connections are now made for the non-inverting mode amplifier. Let us do for it now non-inverting amplifier. We have selected a 1 volt bias, that means sinusoidal wave having amplitude 1 volt at A1, that means this yellow line. So this much is the amplitude of this wave, and you can see it that it is a 1 volt magnitude. Now the output has been selected at A2, and you are getting it is almost double, so it justifies the gain of the non-inverting amplifier. Similarly, you can perform the this kind of analysis for DC voltages also. So by changing a bit of a circuit, we can have the DC connections, and I will do it now. I have selected the DC mode, so I will select the voltages from this. So A2 is output voltage and A1 is input voltage. Now again I will have to select this PV1 to a particular value, say 2.2 volt, and you are getting this A1 is 0.2 volt whereas this is almost 0.4 volt. Similarly, if you increase it a bit again, say 0.5, you will get this kind of observation. If you do it 1 volt, you will get this kind of observation. So both the lines, that means both the potentials, are in positive direction. Therefore this amplifier is called as non-inverting amplifier. It doesn't invert and give you the negative value of the voltages what you have applied at the input. So this completes the inverting and non-inverting amplifier module over here.